Despite China being one of the biggest producers and net exporters of traditional fossil fuel-powered cars, the country's booming electric vehicle scene has offered quite a lot of surprises. One of the biggest selling points of these Chinese electric cars has been the innovative technology they offer at stunningly affordable prices. The newest addition to the global EV industry from China is the Geely Panda Mini, and at just $6,000, the car is as inexpensive as you can get, even by Chinese standards. Originally branded the Geometry 2, the Geely Panda Mini is a rear-wheel drive car that brings some interesting features to the market in the $6,000 price range. So just how good is the Geely Panda Mini? Exterior. As the name implies, one of the first things you notice about the Geely Panda Mini is its cute size and shape. In fact, the Panda Mini closely resembles the Wuling Hongguang Mini AV, which, if you don't know, sells about 20,000 units every single month and is considered the undisputed king of Chinese mini AVs. But of course, you still might not appreciate just how small the Panda Mini EV is. So, for context, the overall length of a Panda Mini EV is well within the wheelbase of a Toyota Hilux. For the styling, Geely opted for the boxy design that made the Wuling Mini AV a success in the global market. However, the Chinese company stuck to the theme not just in the name of the vehicle, but also in the design. The Panda Mini features a pair of crescent moon-esque circular headlights, which are similar to a panda's eyes, while the side mirrors feature a completely black carbon mirror casing to again reinforce the panda theme, since pandas typically have black ears. And that's not all. The Panda Mini comes with 14-inch wheels, which feature alloy trims that closely resemble bear claws. And unlike most Chinese mini AVs, the Panda Mini does feature a slightly higher waistline and a bigger bonnet. As for the rest of the car's exterior design, there is an enormous 64-inch panoramic fixed roof that does two things. It makes sure there is enough light in the cabin and also provides interesting views from inside the vehicle. The rear mirror design is also quite intriguing. There is also geometry branding at the back of the car, which is testament to the geometry brand that the car was originally supposed to launch under. Interior. For a car as small as the Geely Panda Mini, the cabin is actually spacious. The interior design is kept simple, which contributes to the spacious feeling you get when you step into the car. To make up for the affordable pricing, plastic is the main material for the interior decor in the car, but it is very hard to tell thanks to its luxurious finish. What's more, you get to customize the color of your Panda Mini's interior when you order. While the Panda Mini is as compact as you can get for a vehicle, the cabin is quite spacious to ensure comfortable rides for four people. Keep in mind that the rear seats have limited legroom, so you might want to avoid long-distance drives. So, how does this car hold up in terms of cargo space? As you would expect, the cargo space at the back of the car is quite small. However, this limited cargo space is only an issue when all seats are raised. Thanks to the versatile design of the Panda Mini, the rear passenger seats are foldable to accommodate your luggage and other essential cargo you might need to move for your daily errands. Performance and specs. For an EV so cheap, and despite the impressive styling and design, the Panda Mini packs exactly what you need in an urban car designed for inner-city commutes. The Panda Mini is powered by a single electric motor offering 40 horsepower and 110 pound-feet of torque, which is quite impressive for a car as small as the Panda Mini. There is even a cheaper model of the Panda Mini that comes with 27 ponies and 85 pound-feet of torque. Depending on the variant you choose, you get between 120 and 200 kilometers of traveling distance per single charge on the 17.3 kW battery. And according to Geely, it takes just 30 minutes to charge the Panda Mini from 30% to 80% at room temperature. Essentially, you can get your Panda Mini from zero to a full charge within 70 minutes thanks to the 22D2DC charging port on the vehicle. There is also an option to charge the Panda Mini at home using a 2Q charging port, although there is no fast charging support for this port, so to fully top up the Panda Mini battery, it can take up to 8.5 hours. But of course, the Panda Mini AV would not be a true Chinese cheap masterpiece without showing off some impressive technology. Keyless access. Like most electric cars, there is no vehicle key to unlock the Panda Mini. Instead, you have to connect your smartphone to the car's infotainment system to remotely unlock the car. Interestingly, you only need to set this up once. Infotainment system. One of the first things you notice on the dashboard is a 9.2 instrument cluster display, and a central 8-inch touch control screen powered by Android. The touch control screen features Bluetooth compatibility, so you can perform a host of features, including automatically opening the trunk, turning on the AC switching drive modes, streaming music, and much more. Another interesting technology the Chinese company added to the Panda Mini is a reversing camera. The camera streams live footage to the touchscreen infotainment display screen in the cabin dashboard to make driving easier in congested city locations. But that's not all. With the squared-off box-shaped finish of the front and rear exteriors of the Panda Mini, Geely also included rear parking sensors to improve the driving experience for anyone not used to driving a small car. The Panda Mini also boasts two driving modes, Sport and Normal, which are accessible through the 8-inch central touchscreen. With all these interesting features in an electric car priced at just under $6,000 USD, how does the Chinese EV industry do it? Well, in 2022, reports showed that the global EV market was worth US $205.5 billion. This report showed the strength of the industry and just how big it can become. In other words, any country that builds a dominant position now will be well-placed to extract large profits from the market in the future. China, being the world's second-largest exporter of cars, currently has the largest market for electric vehicles and EV producers. In fact, experts in global industries believe the rise of Chinese EVs in the global market will contribute to China overtaking Japan as the #1 car exporter before the end of this year. While there are many contributing factors to the success of the Chinese EV industry, the major factor is the several investments the country continues to make in Chinese EV producers. These investments through subsidies, infrastructure development, technological research, and tax incentives have greatly accelerated innovation and growth. Another contributing factor is the large domestic market that Chinese AV manufacturers have successfully leveraged. These companies have not only focused on developing high-quality EVs suitable for a wide range of audiences, the large domestic market has also made it possible to price the EVs affordably without fear of incurring any loss while also opening up the possibility of making large sales. A good example of just how massive the Chinese domestic market is was back in 2022 when Chinese EV manufacturer BYD managed to sell more electric vehicles in the global EV market than any other manufacturer. It's safe to say the company definitely closed its books in profit. The rapid development of Chinese battery and powertrain technology has also contributed to the massive foothold Chinese EVs are gaining in the global EV market. In the past, one of the biggest downsides of buying a Chinese EV was the limited range they offered despite their affordable pricing. The Chinese EV industry, of course, quickly learned. So now lots of Chinese EV companies have specialized R&D departments making significant advances to improve the range and performance of batteries and powertrains. The new Geely Panda Mini, for instance, offers a range of 200 kilometers with 40 horsepower and 110 pound-feet of torque to handle any urban city commute seamlessly. Looking to the future, it is very easy to see why the Chinese EV industry will continue to set new standards with the innovative electric vehicles they produce. And as the demand for EVs continues to rise globally, Chinese EV companies, with their domestic market and sufficient government backing, are well positioned to produce ingenious and affordable EVs to meet global demands. What are your thoughts on the Geely Panda Mini? And do you think the Chinese EV market can keep offering this range of affordable electric vehicles? Let us know in the comments section below.